I felt like a horrible adult. I was like, yo, look at the world that we've created for these kids, for this to be acceptable in their world. It's just not acceptable, and I don't believe any kid should be exposed to this. What up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today, we are going to be talking about Netflix's Cuties. Now, the Netflix Cuties film has just debuted, and people are livid, okay? When I mean livid, I mean like they're sick. No, like literally sick. And to be honest, I was sick after watching this. So, I watched Cuties, so you didn't have to. Make sure you guys check out My Throne. It is the Mafia group chat. It is only $5 a month if you would like to support. Everything you need is down in the description or in the pinned comment down below. A lot of people were upset that this movie was rated mature, and it's like, oh, why y'all got these little girls in there and you're rating it mature is because y'all got black girls. If y'all watched the movie, maybe you would know. If you made your own opinions instead of going with the majority of social media, you would know. I watched this film and I know why it's rated mature. It makes perfect sense. Because this film was wholeheartedly hard to watch.
This is a hard one. This is a hard one, y'all.
Y'all! I'm going to jail for watching this. I'm 42 minutes in this shit.
We need to do better as a society, y'all.
Miss Ami, I got 53 minutes of this left. Now, I know a lot of you guys had reservations about me even watching the film, but if you do not know me by now, you would know that I make my opinions based on my opinions. I do not need to follow Twitter outrage or, you know, just see a couple clips of like a 2-hour movie and sit there and judge it based off that. I don't think it would be fair to judge a movie based off of clips. Like, yeah, the clips were bad, but even at that, I'm someone that has been into dance my entire life. Like, I'm part of the dance world. I've seen skimpy outfits. I've watched Dance Moms my whole life. I watched Bring It my whole life. And honestly, I really want to start a dance nonprofit later on down the road in my life. Therefore, I genuinely wanted to see what this movie was about because I love me a good dance movie, okay? Honey is actually one of my favorite movies. So I thought it was going to be one of those. So when I started watching it, I realized that this had to be, okay, comment down below because I might be bugging. I don't feel like this film is new because I'm like mignon. Like it's called mignon in French. I hope I'm saying it right because my French is not that good. And I'm like, I feel like I've seen it or I've probably seen something similar to it because there are a lot of French films that are kind of like this. And also when I went to France, there were a lot of dance teams like this little girl's dance team. Like, this was nothing far-fetched to me. Like, I spent 3 months in France back in high school, and like, they were all out here in booty shorts and leather jackets. And I remember this specifically because I used to crack up and be like, what the hell? Like, y'all hot or y'all cool? Like, why y'all got booty shorts and jackets? And at the time, I was like, what, 15, 16? And these little girls was like 12, 11 in booty shorts and jackets, dancing on the train, dancing in the mall. Like, they was just always dancing, and we didn't see anything of it. It's like, dancing is dancing. And watching this film, I can say I seen myself in it only because I've always been dancing. Like, even before I was like doing it in school and church and stuff like that, I've always been dancing, and twerking was not an exception to that. Like, to be honest, I don't see the big deal. Can't be that bad. But I guess I didn't see all the clips that we were talking about because I'm like, the clips I saw weren't that bad, but then I realized I only saw the trailer. So maybe I should watch the clips that went viral. But anyhow, Netflix is being dragged for filth. And yikes, when I watched the movie, I figured out why. Now, I'm going to tell you guys most of the details of this for the simple fact that I'm sure a lot of you guys did not and will not watch it. And to be completely honest with you, I'm very on the fence about it. It was very disturbing, but at the same time, I understand what they were trying to do here. The difference between this movie and that movie, as opposed to me twerking when I was like 11, 12 or whatever, is that we weren't necessarily doing it for the attention of boys or like for the fact that, you know, we were being neglected by our parents at home. And like, it wasn't anything like that. Work amongst ourselves, and like, we would dance at each other's houses, like for parties, like literally, like if there'd be like a baby shower coming, I was like, oh, let's learn this so we could do it at the party. Like it would be little stuff like that. It was not, it was very lighthearted. It wasn't that serious. And with all due respect, a lot of these dances do come from the motherland and it's not sexualized in any way. So I have to pose this question to you guys before I get into the rest of this video, because I really want to know your honest opinion. Is it that twerking and skimpy clothes and just what we deem as sexualizing children, is it really what it is, or is that us as a society that is thinking that way? And I want you to really think before you type your answer to this. Is it us, or is it really sexual? Like, is it us as a society that has deemed this as, oh, we're sexualizing young children? Because out in Africa, Haiti, the Caribbean, all types of stuff, they out here twerking and ain't nobody touching them and stuff and doing all that extra stuff. It's not that serious. Like, you know, they're not doing it for the attention of boys. So it's like, is it us that's just wired to think that it's bad because of, you know, society, because of our parents, because of church? Because, like, why do we think that this is bad? Like, I've seen so many pictures of, like, little girls, and they'll have, like, just a tank top and some shorts. Like a one-year-old, and they're like, oh, that's too grown. Or just, like, doing specific hairstyles.
You make a whole grown.
And I'm like, but is that what you think because you've been brought up to be that way, or is it really sexualizing them? That has a lot to do with us as a society. I really don't think it's the kids. I feel like a lot of kids have pure intentions. They want to have fun. They want to be happy. They want to be able to express themselves. And I feel like they should be able to do that without people trying to say that they're being sexual, being fast, being thotty and all that. I just don't think that's okay. But I have to say that this film was very hard to watch. And I feel like I understand what they were trying to do, but it just was executed horribly. This film really highlights a lot of things that young girls go through, such as transitioning schools, moving away, home conflicts with parents, bullying, body shaming, puberty, lack of school authority and attentiveness to their students, toxic parenting, meddling family. Listen, the list goes on, and I genuinely don't even think I touched on everything that film touches on. As disgusting as this film was, and I will definitely never watch it again, it definitely sticks with me. As nasty as it was, there are a lot of girls out here who are doing this and exhibiting the type of behavior in this film. It doesn't matter what you think. It's real. That's the sad part. It is real. That's why I can't be too mad, because I guess they really wanted to depict reality, but I still believe that they could have done this a better word. But I think it's just like, even though we all know all of this is happening, these kids are on some nasty, you know, stuff, and some of them are into a lot of inappropriate things, and they are being neglected and abused and stuff like that. Even though we know that, I think it's hard to see it spit back at our face on a big screen. That's what it is. I think it's hard for us to really be like, oh my God, like this is what I was doing, or oh my God, this is what this little girl that I know is going through. So the film follows the story of Amy, or Ami. Technically it's Ami, not Amy, but yeah, it's Ami. Her real name is Aminata, and her family is from Senegal. And they just moved to France. It's her and I believe her two younger siblings. Right off the bat, you can tell that Ami has a lot of responsibility that I'm sure a lot of you guys watching can relate to, especially if you come from a black foreign household or a black household nonetheless. I tweeted this a long time ago saying that it sucks that black girls have to grow up so fast. And this film is a perfect example of that. Ami was responsible for grocery shopping. She was responsible for watching her little brother. She was literally forced to grow up at such a young age because her mom was just not around and her dad was back in Africa. So keep that in mind, because that's kind of important to why all of this is happening as well in the film. She has a whole bunch of responsibilities. She has to cook, she has to clean, she has to watch her brother, she has to be responsible for certain things that an adult should really be doing. I really hate how people will sit there and have kids just for them to run errands for them. Like, I understand some parents gotta work. I understand, like, their circumstances, you know, I get it. But at the end of the day, you should always let a kid be a kid. And that's one thing I'm very thankful my parents let me be a kid. They never forced me to do much of anything. They never really asked me to do anything. I did anything that I wanted out of the kindness of my heart. If I did a chore or two, it's because I wanted to. They never forced me to. They never beat me. They never, you know, so I'm very thankful for that, because I do not believe you should have kids just for that. Like, I have a lot of family in France who are out here, can't do nothing. No extracurricular activities, no nothing, because they have to watch their brothers and sisters. And that's just absolutely not okay, and it never will be okay under any type of circumstance. It's one thing if you ask the kid, or you give the kid money to do it, to teach them some sort of responsibility, but to sit there and like ground the kid to do all this housework and essentially be a third parent is just not okay, and it never will be to me. That's just my personal opinion. You can tell that the girl is stressed, she's miserable, and she's also Muslim, and they're basically trying to submerge her in the Muslim religion. However, she doesn't really care too much, and she's always like wandering off during their gatherings in I believe it looks like the building basement. And she comes across a little girl, like a little Hispanic girl, and her name is Angelica, and she's just dancing. Like, you know, she's dancing and she got the moves, okay? She killing it. She, you know, and she's in the laundry room dancing, doing her laundry or whatever. And she sneaks up on her. She sees her dancing. And I guess at this point, she kind of gets amazed by seeing her dancing. Because, I mean, she's African. She's always busy running chores, taking care of her siblings, and then pretty sheltered. She's Muslim. Like, I'm very sure she hasn't been exposed to that type of thing, like seeing girls dance. Or seeing girls with no clothes on, to be honest, because the girl had like a crop top on, all that. See, that's what I don't agree with. The whole crop tops and things, that I think is pretty grown. I guess it became like a, oh my God, like an eye opener to her. So eventually she ends up going to school, and she doesn't really fit in anywhere, but she starts seeing that girl, Angelica, and her friends. So it's a couple of girls that are part of this group. We have Angelica, Kuma, Yasmin. There's another one. There's a little white girl. I don't remember her name. And it doesn't really matter because she didn't really do much. And basically, they are part of a dance crew called the Cuties. In the entire beginning of the film, she basically becomes like kind of like obsessed with figuring out what they're doing and essentially trying to be like, oh my God, like, how can I do that? Like, they look like they're having fun. They look like they're free. They look like, you know, they don't have to wear what I wear. They don't have to go to church. Like, you can tell that's what's festering her mind. Like, she starts popping up to like their dance practices, trying to like look over the gate where they're practicing. They end up throwing a rock at her and it hits her head. They see her. They start bullying her at one point. And it was just really sad to see that they were like bullying her, like throwing her books around. Like, it was really sad to watch all this going on. And now on top of everything she got going on, she is now being bullied. She is just searching for an outlet. And there comes a scene where she basically takes a photo of herself, like a selfie, like a cute little selfie thing. She posts it and she gets no likes. And you can tell that this is really, really like plaguing her deep down inside. And I feel like social media is really a problem. And honestly, I think that's why Instagram considered taking likes away at one point. I heard they were gonna do it, and some people told me that their likes went away already. I haven't seen it, but it makes sense just looking at that. Like, she posted the picture and she was like so sad because she didn't get any likes on it. And like, you could tell she was just craving that attention. Like, her mom's not around, her dad's in Africa. So it's like, she just wants some sort of attention. And it's why I always tell y'all need to fucking talk to your kids. Y'all may not think that, oh my God, like, if I talk to my kid, she's still gonna act up. But she will appreciate it if you keep talking to the kid, okay? He or she will appreciate that you are paying attention to them. And this was a huge, like, that really made me pay attention. Like, I wasn't really paying attention until I saw that. I was like, oh my God. Like, granted, I do not think kids should be on social media. Like, you should not be under the age of 12. Like, even 12 is a little young. Like, I would say maybe 14, 16 at this point, of all of the nasty, disgusting shit that's on social media. It could really damage your kid. Now we move on to the scene in the bathroom. Now there's a scene in a bathroom stall where basically she is eavesdropping on the girls' conversation, and they're basically talking about sex. And they're 11, y'all. 11, 12. This is where I started to get annoyed, but I had to think about it, and I was like, yo, when I was 11, I definitely knew about this stuff too. And I'm like, gosh, it's just hard to see this thrown back at you. This conversation was like wild. They were talking about like peen sizes, and one of the girls was saying how she saw her brother's peen and it wasn't that big. And then they were talking about that word right here. They were talking about this, and they were saying when it happens, the peen goes through your mouth. And I'm like, what in the world is going on? Like, it was hard to hear little kids talking about this, but what was really hard was hearing how uneducated they were about this. And I'm gonna touch on that a little later as well. Ami is basically listening to these girls' conversations in the bathroom stall. So she's in the stall and they're in the bathroom itself. And she comes out and she's like, oh, what y'all looking at? And it was like, oh, we're looking at a peen. Do you have a brother? Which is strange that they're talking about their brother's peens. And then there's a boy that that they see that they think is like really, really cute, and they start, you know, oh my god, he's so cute, you know, regular girl shit, and they dare on me to go and take a picture of the boy's peeing while he goes to pee in the boy's bathroom. So he tries to take a picture of the boy. The boy gets mad, starts yelling at her, telling her to get out of the bathroom. It was just yikes. Just oh, child. Now I have to pause here and tell you guys what happened to Ami's dad. So Ami's dad is in Africa getting ready to come over to France with his new wife. Yes, he is in a poly marriage and he just got a new wife. And he's bringing her over there to live with them as well. And of course, Ami is not happy about this. And honestly, I know there's a lot of African families that are like this where, you know, the man or the woman has multiple partners. But I believe if you are going to do that, you have to explain it to your children in a way that they will understand and not be upset. Because this affects Ami so greatly, and it's literally the underlying theme for this entire film. She is highly upset that her dad's not there. And then when she finds out that her dad is marrying another woman and that it's affecting her mother, it really hurts her to her core. She's basically overhearing conversations of her mom talking to other people about how she feels about this and how she's not happy with it. She's hearing her mom cry. She's seeing and hearing her mom hit herself. It's very sad. And this is, again, you need to watch what you do around your kids, because you may think your kids aren't listening, but they are. There's a lot of things I've seen my parents do and say, and they thought I was not around, like sleep or something, and I was like right at the door or under the bed or in the closet. You feel me? You guys need to be very, very careful, because kids are not dumb. Understand that. It don't matter how young the kid will remember. There's a lot of crazy things that I remember. Like, she was crying because she was seeing her mom crying. So at this point, I believe she's becoming really, really defiant. And this is evident in the fact that there is a master bedroom in the house, you know? And this master bedroom is supposed to be for her dad and his new wife. So right away, you can tell that he's literally treating his new wife with prestige. Like, this new wife is about to get the bomb by the bomb. Like, she's like getting everything. She got the master bedroom. Meanwhile, everybody else stays in the rest of the house. The door is locked with the key and everything. Like, you can tell that this new wife is being treated better than her mom. Angie ends up befriending her in the hallway because she helped her get away from her toxic brother, because he's yelling and cursing at her and chasing her down the hallway. She runs into Ami's apartment. They become friends. So she breaks into the room with Angie and they start jumping on the bed. They're eating candy. I have no idea how they didn't get caught doing that shit. You know, just having a grand old time being girls, honestly. This is honestly the only lighthearted moment in the entire movie. And I was like, oh, this is so cute. That part I liked. After that, everything went left. Because while they're in this bedroom, Angie gets on her phone and she starts looking at a rival dance team. Okay, remind you, Angie is part of the Cuties dance team. And she starts looking at this dance team called the Swag Sweeties. Ain't nothing sweet about these girls, y'all. At this point, if I wasn't making this video right now, I would have shut it off. So, of course, little outfits, tank top, little ass skirt, makeup, like, but these girls looked a little older. They looked to be like maybe 15-ish, like 14, 15. But still, the outfits were cringe. And then when they started dancing, I was like, and then one of the girls had the nerve to lift her shirt and her boob popped out. Like, it was completely intentional. It was like a, and I was like, at this point, I knew I messed up and I should have never watched this movie. But this is what happens when you want to form your own opinions, people. So I had to pause, I had to collect myself, I had to drink my wine, because I was like, what is this? I was like, how is this on the screen? Like, what in the world? Like, no. I would hope that these are just like really, really young looking actors and they're actually over the age of 18. I would hope, but I'm sure that's not. Angie starts talking about how they are their biggest rivals and they don't like them. These are children and they out here like, oh, these bitches, da da da. And I'm like, uh-oh. Like, oh, woo child, the ghetto. I was like, I'll put soap on it. That shit hurt me and she wasn't even talking about me. So during this, you know, Angie's like, yeah, we gotta beat them in the competition. And, you know, at this point, they start getting Ami involved in the group, you know, and now they got her jumping fences, wearing crop tops. But yeah, she's literally stealing her little brother's clothes to try to look more groomed. Oh god, you know, she ain't got no crop top, so she gotta wear just a smaller shirt. And she's trying to like wear the baggy pants. And it was just, oh my god. And it's like, yo, the little girl's putting makeup on her. It's just so wild. And it's like, yeah, this is what happens when you don't want your damn kids, okay? Because up to this point, I think we're about like 30 something minutes into the film, and not once has anyone tried to talk to this girl about anything that she's going through. And even though things haven't really kicked up yet, you can tell there's a lot of subtle shit. Like, the girl is definitely suffering internally, and it doesn't seem like anyone seems to care or even notice what she's going through. So it is at this point that we see the cuties dance. Let me just say this right now. I think the girls have dancing capability, but whoever did this choreography needs help. And this is my this is definitely the problem with this, right? It wasn't even just the dancing. It was the dancing in conjunction with the outfits, in conjunction with the cinematography. That's the problem. It's not even the fact that there's little girls twerking in little clothes on a movie. It's the fact that they got little girls twerking in little clothes on a movie, and then they sitting there zooming in on their butt, zooming in on their, like, who the fuck? Like, who had these cameras? Like, that's what I don't understand. Like, I understand y'all wanted to show that little girls be twerking and being provocative, but, like, y'all didn't have to zoom into their butts and shit. Like, that was just absolutely unnecessary. And that's where I was like, all right, nah, just no. Just no. Like, why? Just why? And then the choreography was just garbage. But I mean, I guess they are 11, so I guess that was the point. But it was just like, it just was not good choreography, like, at all. Like, it was just like, ugh, it was very subpar. Like, did y'all, like, pay his first grader to teach them this shit? Like, oh god, it was bad. At this point, we start to see our first little bit of body shaming, because Ami is basically, like, filming all of this, and then they start talking about her, and they're like, oh, you're so flat, basically saying she has no butt. I used to get that all the time growing up. I used to hate that, because I was, like, really, really small. Flat, she's so flat. Like, oh my god, you have no butt. Like, they were really, like, coming at her. And there was a Yasmin was, like, the heavier set girl of the group as well. And there was a comment that someone made about her losing weight. And I was like, wow, like, this is just horrible. Like, the first dance wasn't that bad. I'm just telling you this right now. The first dance that they were doing wasn't that bad. Like, the cuties' original little choreography wasn't even that serious, honestly, compared to the rest of the shit. Let me tell y'all. Ami starts watching provocative music videos. You know, the music videos you and me see on a daily basis. Actually, no, not I, because I do not watch music videos anymore, because I just don't see the point of them. And also, a lot of them are just really basic and just substanceless, like, just no substance whatsoever. So I really haven't watched a music video in probably months, years maybe. Oh no, I watch Woyoy. Make a scream like Woyoy, big girl play with big toy. I like that song. Go check out Miss RF Fabulous, okay? That's my song. That's the last music video I've seen. Like, I do not watch music videos, I don't care for them. But of course, she watches the music videos that have the booty popping, them dancing on the ground. Oh god, like, and it's crazy because I had to think back, like, damn, back in my day we was definitely listening to ooh, she walla walla, she do her thing and it's getting hot in here, so take off all your clothes, work it, I need a glass of water. We was definitely listening to all of this. So it's like, can I be that mad that they're showing kids doing what I used to do? Like, honestly, I can't be mad at kids doing what I did. But what I can say is life is different. Back then, I can say I didn't understand none of that shit like that. Like, I really didn't understand the music. I did know about sex and stuff, but that was from other reasons. However, I didn't really know what the music meant. And when we would be dancing and stuff like that, like I said, it was for us. We weren't sitting there doing this shit in front of boys, them ugly little dusty hood boogers. Like, that's not what we were trying to do. It was all pure and innocent, especially since we didn't know what was going on really in terms of the music. But these kids internalize it now. Like, I feel like these kids are way more smarter and they really can understand what's going on. And what's funny is people will sit there and tap for these types of songs and music videos. And I feel like that's probably why I stopped watching them, because I just don't see that it does any substance, you know, throwing money, riding nice cars, the big booty bitches. Like, what is the point? Like, what does that do for you? Like, I just don't see the point. And I do feel like it can be very detrimental. So it's very interesting, because we'll sit there, like right now, I'm defending this in a way, because it's like, that is the culture. But it's like, but is it detrimental? Is that okay for it to be our culture? Because our kids are looking at this. But then you can easily be like, okay, well, watch your kid. But it's like, okay, but what does that do for you as an adult? Sitting there watching this booty shaking, all this shit, it don't do nothing for you. Just don't. Like, why is it that other music genres, like, why is it like white dominated type shit doesn't usually have that much provocative tones to it. But with music videos with black people, black music, it's usually expected. And I'm like, wow, I think we have a problem. Like, this really made me like think like, shit. I felt like a horrible adult. I was like, yo, look at the world that we've created for these kids, for this to be acceptable in their world. It's just not acceptable, and I don't believe any kid should be exposed to this. So Ami starts picking up on all of this choreography and tries to like learn it. You know, you see her trying to dance in the bathroom, y'all. At this time, she hasn't really joined the cuties to dance yet. She's just holding the camera. She's like a little, she just got added to the group, and they don't even know the girl can dance yet. Now you can tell this girl has way too much time on her hands. This girl's never danced in her life. Okay, she doesn't know anything about this newly found music and stuff like that. And now she's teaching herself how to dance in the bathroom. This just goes to show that y'all need to watch your damn kids. This also goes to show that everyone wants a kid, but not everyone wants the responsibility of having a kid. Especially when it comes to foreign people, I feel like a lot of them just have kids for the satisfaction of having them, just to please other people, just to please the family, just to like, you know, live out their name. They don't really care to do much of anything, like except for feed the kid and clothe the kid and make the kid go to school. They feel like as long as you do those three things, you're a great parent. When in actuality, being a parent has a lot of other shit to it. Like, this is just it was very hard to watch. Like, I don't know how to tell them to say it, but it was hard to watch. So next thing you know, her dad finally calls, and I'm like, oh my god, finally we're gonna get some positive interaction. So her mom's like, Ami, it's your dad on the phone. And she takes the phone. You know what she does? She throws the phone out of the window. Yes, she drops it out of the window. That is a very strong statement of detest. Okay, so at this point, I'm like, oh, no pedicimula, no pedilla. It's lost. That's it. That's it. Game over. Shit about to turn up. And I was right. So Ami's behavior starts to get a little out of control at this point. Her and her friends are out here trying to lie to boys about their age. Luckily, she fucked shit up because she said their real age, but they're trying to lie and say they're like 14. But Ami's like, no, we're 11. And then, you know, they got mad at her, of course. But it's like, wow, like, this is what kids do. And I remember there was this other little girl. I used to love her so much. I used to call her my daughter. I'm not going to say no names because people are going to know what I'm talking about. And I witnessed her trying to do this. Like, I was like maybe 17. And I saw one of my friends from high school, but he had went to a different school. And he was with his friends and he was trying to talk to her. And I'm like, this bitch is like 12. And I'm like, why are you hanging out with the 12-year-old? He was like, what? She said she was 15. I said, bro, she's 12. Like, and I blew her shit up. And she was up, like, she was so mad. And I'm like, don't you ever do that. Like, what the fuck is wrong with you? Like, I was so upset. Like, he was like 16, 17 at the time, thinking she was 15. And she's fucking 12. Do not lie about your age. You can get into a lot of serious shit. And that boy or girl can get into a lot of trouble for messing with you, thinking that you're older than what you are. So do not lie about your age. They sitting there talking about Kim K and talk about all of this extra shit, putting makeup on each other. And Kuma, which is the other black girl, goes to blow up a condom that she found. A used condom. She's blowing it up like a balloon. And everybody's like, oh my god, like, why would you touch that? That's a condom. That's disgusting. Like, people with AIDS have sex with that. You'll get cancer if you touch it. Now, this is what I mean about sexual maturity and, like, them just, like, not being educated about shit that I said before. It's like, wow. Like, it's crazy because these kids know what sex is, but they don't know anything. Really? You'll get cancer from touching a used condom? People with AIDS have sex with condoms? No, people want to be safe, don't want to get pregnant, don't want to get STDs. Have sex with condoms. You're not gonna get cancer from touching a condom, even a used condom. Like, it was just so wild. They start screaming and, oh my god, don't touch us, Kuma, don't touch us. And Kuma is like, she's shaking because she's like, I mean, I didn't know. Like, it's not my fault. I don't know what it was. That was deep. That, my friends, was when I was like, yikes, we need to start educating kids, bro. Because, like, she really didn't know what it was. She thought it was like a balloon. She didn't know it was a condom. She didn't know. I'm sure she knew what a condom was, but she didn't know what it looks like in person. So she sat there blowing it up thinking it's a balloon. That's disgusting. Oh my god. Ugh. That's when it really hit me, like, yo, we really don't talk to our children about these things. Like, we really don't. So as you guys can see, there's a lot of important themes emerging in this so far. Like, even though it's hard to watch, it's like, okay, now I see the point of the film. You know, like, it really brought me back to the ignorance of the world, because I'm sure they've heard that numerous places. You know, people always associate, like, you know, oh, people with AIDS use condoms and stuff like that. People always say ignorant shit like that. And we need to understand when we say ignorant things like that, it does translate to our children. Educate your kids, even if it's hard to have the conversation, because then they end up like this. Okay, Kuma is crying and they're basically trying to cleanse the girl. Okay, they're sitting there washing her mouth with soap. It was just a mess. So now we get into this whole situation where they're trying to like catfish a cute boy that they tried to have Ami take a picture of in the bathroom online. So I guess they get on like some type of Skype or Uhu type thing, and they're trying to talk to him, but they don't have the video on. So I guess they somehow connect with him so they can see him, but they can't see them, and they're like all like crowded around the laptop. And you know, they don't want to turn the camera on because clearly they're all little ass girls and he knows that they're little ass girls. So somehow, some way, Yasmin accidentally presses the, you know, the camera button, and it shows Angie's face, and Angie is embarrassed because the boy starts going off on her like, little girl, leave me alone, go play with your dolls. Like he came at her. He had to do all of that. Clearly, Angie is embarrassed. Yasmin starts to feel bad or whatever. But it gets to a point where Yasmin is basically kicked out of the group. But I don't think Yasmin knew that per se, because she ends up trying to come up to her a day or so later after the altercation. And Angie literally lunges at her and tries to beat her up. Well, does beat her up. She beats Yasmin's ass. Like, she is slapping her silly. Yasmin's not even hitting her back. Yasmin's sitting here like this. She's like, what do you want? What do you want? These are 11-year-olds. Bro, she is slapping her silly. Bow, 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 bow. Watosh, watosh, watosh. Like, I was like, yikes. Ratchet Television has entered the chat. Where do these kids learn this shit from? Besides us, Ratchet Television, society, music videos. Jasmine gets beat up and essentially gets kicked out of the group. The school finally intervenes. Finally, like they already done fought. They already done fought. The school comes mad late into the situation, breaking them apart. And it was just like, oh my God. Like, it was just wow. And this is very important because it comes in later. Now, since Angie is out of the competition, they are down a dancer. Ami offers to fill in her spot, and Angie is concerned because she's like, I do not have the time to teach you the steps. And Ami's like, no, I can dance and I know the steps. And she shows her the steps. She's like, what the hell? Like, wow, girl, you can dance. Like, okay, fine. I don't know how everybody else gonna feel about it, but hey, this gonna just have to do for now. She's in the team and she starts teaching them some moves. Okay, let me tell you this. Let me remind you, she don't got no experience in doing any of this, and she literally just learned this from provocative music videos. So at this point, I knew I fucked up, for real, for real. She's doing the crybaby. For those of y'all who know, if you are 25, maybe 21, right? I'll say maybe even 20 and older, you would know what the crybaby is. The crybaby is that move on the floor where you twerk while you're literally laying on a, yes. They're doing the crybaby. They're doing the doggy shaking their booties. They touching their twats and licking their fingers. And Ami is the one teaching them how to do this. You know how they always say, oh, it's the quiet ones. It's the religious ones. It's the ones that you think be the good girls. This was definitely representative of that. She is literally sitting there teaching these girls how to look sexy. Like, kitchen. Well, Ami is teaching these girls some new tricks, some new moves or whatever. And that's when they go to make this video, I guess, like trying to promote their new dance moves. She's supposed to be the sheltered one, and she's the one that got all the moves, okay? So, you know, they film it, and disgusting. Just utterly disgusting. It just didn't, it didn't sit right with me whatsoever, because again, the choreography was horrible, and then now it's like extremely provocative. It was disgusting. So it is at this point that we find out Angie's story, which is that, you know, her parents don't pay her much mind, and she doesn't get really good grades, so they really don't pay her much mind. Basically talk down on her, saying that she's like, you know, a disgrace, you know, things like that. They always call her a failure, and you know, that really hurts her. She starts to say how her parents don't even know that she dances, and they don't really support anything that she does. All they do is work. I believe they own some sort of a shop or something like that. So it's like usually just her and her brother, and she always feels isolated. So I'm like, okay, so we have a whole bunch of broken girls, and we're surprised that they twerking. Like, if anything, I guess people are more mad that this is being showcased. But again, this is real. Like, this is what happens to a lot of people. Now, this is when I start getting upset, because I just hate parents or adults who are like this, because they start prepping Ami to be a woman. And their way of teaching her or prepping her to be a woman is by making her prepare some of the food for her father's wedding. We already know this is not going to go well, because she don't like her father. I mean, she threw the whole goddamn phone out of the window when he called. So her aunt, okay, I forgot to mention this Yeah, I should have mentioned this because this goes with the theme of the meddling family. Her aunt is always basically trying to raise her and tell her what to do and tell her mom what to do with her. And that's also a huge annoyance that I know a lot of people are going through. So her aunt is the one that gives her this task and gives her the task to cut like maybe like 50 onions. Y'all already know it sucks to cut a onion. Can you imagine cutting like 50? So she literally cuts off this massive like bunch of onions and she realizes that she has to be at this dance audition and she's missing it. So she runs off to like go get changed, but she starts seeing like blood on her and she's like, don't know what this is, but I gotta go. So she puts on the outfit or whatever, goes to the audition, and she realizes that she's missed audition. And you know, she runs back home only for her aunt to sit there and be like, where were you? How dare you defy me? You know, that whole entire speech that African parents be having for y'all or whatever. And basically that's when she sees that she's bleeding, because like now the blood has seeped through her pants, and at this point, yeah, she's gotten her period. And she's like, oh, you know, she eased up, like, oh, you're a woman now, you know, let me teach you what to do. Goes to the bathroom, teaches her. See, again, I understand, yeah, she's bleeding right then and there. You should definitely, you know, teach her what to do at this point, because now she's bleeding then and there. But again, another example of how she's a meddling aunt, like she's meddling, like you should let the mom teach her how to do things. And it's crazy because later after that, the mom comes into the room and is like, oh, you're a woman now. And Ami just looks at her and they just look at each other and the mom walks away. And I'm like, what the hell is this? Like, no sex talk? No, this is what's happening to you? No, this is what you should do next time? No, are you in pain? Do you want an Advil? No, are you craving any snacks? You want me to go get you some candy? What in the hell? Yo, oh my God. This infuriated me. And I don't know if she didn't say anything because she wasn't comfortable, if she didn't say anything because she felt like, oh, well, the aunt did it anyway. She think that she a parent. Granted, especially with going on with her dad, I do think that the mom was like very depressed. Like the entire movie, I think the mom's depressed. She doesn't say much in the movie, but you can tell like she is just not happy at all. So of course the girls are mad at Ami for missing the audition, but they get over it. There is also a scene where they end up accidentally walking into like a laser tag thing where, you know, you have to pay to get in. The guards come and they're like, you guys aren't supposed to be here without, you know, paying for it. They threaten to call their parents. They're like, no, please don't, please don't. And the guy tries to grab one of the girls. All of a sudden the girls start calling him a pedophile, and I was like, oh my God. Girls, women, don't just sit there and call someone a pedophile or try to say someone's doing something to you when they're not. Yeah, you shouldn't put your hands on them, but it's like pedophile though, it's ridiculous. So then his boss comes out and is like, what's going on here? And they're like, oh yeah, your employee over here is trying to touch on us, da da da. So you already know that becomes an issue. So they start going back and forth. And then notice that they have moved to the finals of this competition type thing, or you know, they did really good on their audition. So they start getting happy, you know, screaming, and they're like, what the fuck is wrong with y'all? And nigga, like, we're dancers, so like you can't call our parents because like we're dancers. And they were like, dancers? So you know, Ami starts doing her thing, and it was just, oh God, in front of these two grown men. And what's very nasty about this is like the boss that came second is like literally like mesmerized at Ami, like shaking her butt, dropping it like it's hot, and oh, it was disturbing. Ooh, the pedophilia. No, her mom ended up passing out, which was crazy, just like out of nowhere, which definitely could have been traumatic. But to be honest, I feel like she didn't react to it. Her little brother reacted to it because clearly because he's younger, but I feel like it probably touched her more on the inside because she didn't really do much on the outside. And this is the bum video scene. Now the bum, y'all know that song Bum or whatever. Yeah, they post the video. I don't have to tell you about the choreography. Clearly it's nasty. They have little ass clothes on, zooming in on the butts, the basic, the regular for this damn film. They post the video up on social media and the video goes viral. And Ami was like in the spotlight because she was really killing it in there or whatever. And at this point, she thinks she a baddie. She thinks she a brand new bitch. She brand new after this video. Like, she goes viral. So she comes into the school next day, hair all out, crop top, new pants. Listen, she a new bitch. She a new bitch. I don't say bitch because she's a kid, but she a new bitch. Looking fleet, everyone's looking at her. People looking at her up and down. Cause you know, some people jealous. You know when you go viral, niggas be acting like they don't know you to be. That's what was going on. People just like, you know, y'all know. know how that shit go in middle school. But at this point, as you guys can tell from what I told you guys before, now she's getting the likes. When she was sitting there posting little selfies, no one was liking her pictures. But when she out here shaking her shit like bum, 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 people was like, ooh, 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 and she got the lie, 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 lie. So she's really feeling herself at this point. So she's walking through the hallways, meets up with the other cuties, and they're like, yes, did you see yourself, girl? Everyone loves you. Everyone saw it, da, 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 da. And eventually, you know, they walk out to the courtyard. A jealous bitch throws a can at them. I believe it was a bitch from the Swag Sweeties or whatever. And Ami goes to literally beat the girl up. Remember? Angie did that to Yasmin. Now, Ami is doing this to a random girl who threw a can at her. We went from shy, quiet, reserved, respectful to who you think you are. I will tear your eyes out your eye sockets, bro. Like, she went ham on the girl. I was shocked. Like, it was like a switch. I was like, oh, petit. Ragged the girl, and she had her. She had her until the girl gets on top of her. Somehow she ends up being flipped over, and they pull her pants down, and, you know, they see her panties, and I guess she had like baby panties on, as they call them. And you know, people started making fun of them. People were recording it. Yes, people were recording this whole fight, recording her panties being shown to the world. She also gets in trouble for going out on a shopping spree. Where the fuck did they get the money? I have no idea. It's crazy, but like on the shopping spree, she took it upon herself to go buy more adult looking panties. Jesus. So people start talking shit about the cuties, saying that you know, they're babies, and you know no one wants to be called a baby, especially when you're a preteen. That's something like you really don't want to be called. So you know, Angie is talking to Ami about it. She's like, god, girl, we have to do something about this video. Like, people are saying we're babies and I don't know what to do. Like, this shit making us look bad, you know, just regular shit. And Ami's like, yeah, I know, whatever. And at this point, she gets caught up. So I didn't mention this in the beginning, but I'm gonna mention it now. Ami stole a phone from, I don't know who this guy was, because I wasn't paying attention to that. I don't know if it's her cousin or something, some sort of family friend of some sort, but whatever, she stole a phone from him like weeks ago, it looks like, and he was looking for it and couldn't find it, but the whole time she stole it. Her parents did not give her a phone. No one gave her a phone. She had no job to get a phone. I don't know if you guys caught on to it, but how did she get a phone? Yeah, she stole it. So already you could tell this girl's been exhibiting very toxic behavior, especially due to her circumstances. And she gets caught because the guy comes in the house and, you know, he's walking past and he sees her talking. He's like, what the fuck is that, my phone? He grabs it from her. She's like, give it back, give it back. You know, they start, you know, going back and forth. And he's like, no, I'm not giving you back the phone. Like, why would you steal it from me? You know, her response to try to get the phone back is for her to try to take her clothes off. I'm not joking. I'm not joking. She's like, give the phone back. He's like, no. She's like, kid, y'all not. I'm not about to do that because I need my coin. But yeah, she literally starts to strip in front of this grown boy. He has to be like 17, probably older than that, like maybe 18. He's probably over the age. The point is, way older than her. Even if they were the same age, that is not how you solve shit. The fact that now her ideology is translating from, okay, if I want to get what I want, I just have to strip for it. Wow. Of course, the man gets upset. Okay, this boy gets mad as fuck. He pushes her, actually. She runs into the bathroom and locks herself in the bathroom with the phone after she somehow manages to get it. At this point, she takes a cootie pic. Yeah, she takes a cootie pic and posts the cootie pic on social media to prove that her and the cuties is grown. Oh, this backfires really badly. The cuties get real upset. Everyone is calling them thots and hoes and bitches and shit like that. And it becomes a very, very serious issue when someone actually calls her a hoe in the classroom while she's walking up to the chalkboard. So, you know, she starts going back and forth with the boy, and the boy's like, no, like, I'm not taking it back. Like, you're the one putting cootie pics up on you on the internet. Like, what you think people gonna think about you? She takes a pencil and she stabs him in the hand with it in the classroom. Yes. Y'all can see the progression of what is going on here. Like, it's crazy because this is like such a short amount of time, and her personality has done a huge 360. Her mom literally rages at her. At this point, she's like, I don't know who you are. You're not my daughter. I should kill you, which was a very harsh line. You never say that to a kid. And like, you know, she slapped her. It was a scene. It was a whole big debacle. And it was so sad because you can see like everything is just spiraling out of control at this point. Like, she out here stabbing kids with pencils. Like,
what is going on?
They even, at one point in the movie, they got, like, started having, like, a exorcism type of situation, but clearly it didn't work. And then there was another time where they had someone come and pray over her. Like, it's just, it's a mess, and none of it worked. So for y'all that love to be like, oh, she need Jesus, she need God, all she needs is church, all you need is this, no, that doesn't do much of anything. You need to change from yourself, within yourself. Like, at the end of the day, there's no magic in anything. Like, things do happen, but and shit like this, you need to actually parent and pay attention to what your kid needs. Now, of course, her friends are mad at her at this cootie pic, because now she's stabbing people, she making niggas look bad, the shit is on the social media, like, it's just, like, she's making everyone look bad in the group. So they kick her out the group, and they go befriend Yasmin again, and now Yasmin is back in the group, and I guess they revise some of the dance moves, and Ami is upset. She is trying to get them to practice, she's trying to get them to dance, she wants to be in the competition. But even they are looking at her like there's something wrong with you, because her behavior has been completely out of control. All of them were some badass kids, okay? All of them were some babies. She is no longer a part of the cuties, and she is not having it. She's very upset by this. And, like, she's just, like, rebelling on all ends. Even so much so that the day of the actual competition, she sees Yasmin on her way there, and she pushes her in a river with no remorse. Yasmin was pushed and she was literally gasping for air, like screaming and everything. And Ami just stood there and looked at her in the water, didn't try to save her, didn't have no concern. Like, she literally pushed her and her face was like this. I was like, oh, hell no. Oh my God, I thought she would have, like, oh, are you okay? Do you need some help? No, she did not give a fuck. I guess she waited to see that she didn't die, because eventually Yasmin ended up, like, holding on to one of those, like, you know, those things in the water that you can hold on to just in case you're drowning. She ends up finding one of those and she holds on to it, and she runs off to the competition, outfit and all, and they're all like, excuse me, like, why are you here? Like, where's Yasmin? And, you know, it's like maybe like 5 minutes to showtime. They're like, you know, we don't have time to deal with this. I mean, she dances better than Yasmin anyway, so fuck it, let's just do it with her. Y'all, this dance routine, I don't even think adults should dance like this. That's how bad the dance routine was. It was absolutely disgusting, repulsive. I had a headache after watching this shit. Mind you, this is the day of her dad's wedding, okay? At this point, the dad has come back. The dad is the new wife with him. So it's like, she's supposed to be getting ready for the wedding, but she's out here shaking ass on the stage. And the audience is upset. The audience is like, what the fuck is this? Because this is a little girl twerking on stage. Like, it's not cute. So the audience is like booing them. The judges are like disgusted. It was just wow. And the funny thing is, they looked so happy with themselves. They looked so happy. They were like, yeah, like, we did that. And I'm like, whoa. Well, clearly, I'm sure they didn't win the competition, because I saw nothing about it after that. So shortly, basically, she, you know, people are looking at her like, girl, you're supposed to be at the wedding, da, da, da. And she runs back home. She has the thought fit on. Listen, the booty shorts, the top. And her aunt's like, what the fuck are you doing? Why do you have that on? Why aren't you at the wedding? Why, like, going off? And the mom's like, leave her alone. And she's like, no. But the mom's like, leave her alone. She's like, no. But so at this point, her mom finally stands up for herself and is like, leave her alone. Like, this is my kid type shit. She straight up tells Aminata, like, listen, you do not have to go to the wedding if you don't want to. And that's that. And basically, that's how the movie ends, with her jumping rope outside, finally doing something childlike. Wedding is going on downstairs in, like, the basement common area type thing. She doesn't attend, and literally that is how the movie ends. So yeah, if you guys got all the way to the end of this video, please make sure you comment down your story in terms of, how did your parents treat you, and do you think it has a grave effect on who you are today? Overall, I believe the film was very disturbing, only because it was executed very poorly. I understand the point, I understood the themes, I understood the lessons to be learned. However, it was not done properly, only because the choreography, in conjunction with the outfits, in conjunction with the videography, was very tasteless and depicted these girls in a very disturbing, provocative light that no kid should be shed in. Likewise, I do believe that the film was very authentic. Was it wrong for them to do it the way they did it? Yes. But the film was very authentic. It was really real and showed what these little girls go through. And I see a lot of people jumping down these kids' throats who are trying to advocate for it. Like, I wouldn't call it art, because I see these kids calling it art or whatever. I wouldn't call it art, but I would say that it really tells their story. And if I was 11-year-old going through this, resonating with these girls in the film, I would say that it was authentic and probably rally for it too. And I'm not an 11-year-old girl, I'm a 25-year-old girl that did used to twerk at 11. So I understand where they're coming from. I just don't agree with the choice of language and the choice of angle that they choose for this. Like, there's a way to do certain things, and this was definitely not the way to do it. I don't know if they should take the film off. Like, I feel like anyone should watch it. I feel like you will be able to extract something useful from it, even if you can't get past the dancing, just fast forward through it, to be honest. But it's very telling. Like, it really is. And I find it interesting because people always like, oh, well, we want real things. We want real depictions. Or why can't black girls have positive movies? Why can't black girls do this? Why can't black girls get that? I hate that every single time we see black women on the big screen, it's them being provocative. It's them being repulsive. It's them being used, abused, you know? However, we have to be real with ourselves. That's what a lot of the reality is for a lot of black girls. A lot of black girls are being used and abused. A lot of black girls are promiscuous for a lot of reasons. A lot of black girls do have a lot of heavy topics and a lot of heavy situations that they are going through. And I don't think that people who choose to showcase this to try to make them their issues be more humanized and more realized is a problem. I just feel like there's a way to execute it. And this is a perfect example of a way not to execute it. I do think the film had a purpose. I just don't feel like many people got the purpose because of the way it was executed. Therefore, the film was a complete fail. You can do whatever you want, however you want to do it, but the whole point of a film is for people to watch it and for people to see it and for people to get a lesson from it. And in this sense, you didn't get any lessons because a lot of people didn't even fucking watch it. A lot of you guys watching this right now probably just watched my review and that's it. You're not gonna go watch it. You don't wanna, you know, whatever. So it's like, the whole essence of the film is now lost because of the way they chose to execute it. And it's a damn shame because I feel like a lot of people can learn something from this. Yeah, this was a very long video. Like I said, comment down below, what are your stories? And let me know, did you watch it? Why or why not? And let me know, what was an important lesson that you took from it? So with that being said, make sure you like, share, subscribe, do all that. And I'm gonna see y'all next time.